There are two sides to Nalida. The one the outside world sees, jovial and sweet, effervescent and light. But then, the music starts. The lights go down, and Nalida transforms into this. This is her world, Nalida Terrado. Her sanctuary, the dimly lit basement of a dance studio where her friends can belt out music and she can lose herself in it. And the dance Nalida is currently immersed in is flamenco, a Spanish folkloric art form that is far too complex to explain in this intro. Besides, I want to focus on this talented human.
Everything is going on. Life is amazing.
So tell me, how did your journey into flamenco begin?
Just kind of came across it by accident. My mom was searching for bomba en plena classes as a child. She did find a local small school near my home where they offered ballet and Spanish dance, flamenco being part of Spanish dance. And it was almost something that I was like captivated from immediately.
How old were you when you started?
I was 5.
You were 5 years old when you started?
Yeah, just yesterday.
Is this the traditional flamenco ensemble? This is what it is?
Sometimes it doesn't, but it usually has lots of ruffles. These are flecos, which
flecos.
Are fringe, F-L-E-C-O-S.
I will never look down and say, great flecos. Is the outfit just based on the movements? Like, so when you move, these certain parts kind of move with you?
People like to choose what outfits they're used based on the form that they're dancing in.
Right.
So it's a very somber number. Then they'll probably choose something that's a little bit more on the darker side.
Yeah.
Red has always been the color of passion and fire.
So you're feeling passionate right now.
I'm very passionate.
I can sense that. Anytime you see somebody dancing flamenco, you see their face and you see the emotions in their face. And it's a combination of so many different things.
It's honest and everyone has something really different to contribute to it because we're all different people. Flamenco has been my voice. Flamenco has been my power. Flamenco has been the way that I've connected with people in ways that words don't suffice. These are flamenco shoes. I have nails in the heel,
oh, wow.
Nails in the toe, and this is rubber. And it has a cap around the toes so that you can use the toes for sound.
There's clapping involved, right?
There's clapping.
Yeah. That's a good clap.
Try it.
Nope, not so much.
Can I show you?
Sure.
There's two different kinds. So this is another instrument.
Like right.
The hand is an instrument. The feet are an instrument. This one. And then you have another one where you cup your hands together.
And what's that called?
And those are palmas sordas.
Palmas sordas.
And it's ever changing. So I can be like this today and tomorrow I may be completely blue and it's completely all right and I'm gonna sweat it out and then it'll be fine.
Can you dance flamenco with a partner? Can you do it with partners or is it usually a solo act?
There is a folk, like a street dance that is done in Sevilla.
Right.
And that is a partner dance. That's really the only partner dance per se that exists unless it's something that's choreographed.
I'm glad because if you stepped on my foot while flamenco, I think I'd die.
I think you would die because I've stepped on my foot
really?
Many times.
But Nalida's dancing is only half the story because the musicians she brought were equally as remarkable.
Noticing anytime you play music, Nalida can't sit still. From what I've heard of flamenco music, is it ever just like cheerful?
Well, you wanna think of flamenco music, just to give you a comparison, kind of like the blues, mm-hmm. where you're talking about real life situations. So this has evolved into the cry of the town. I mean, everywhere from racial problems to this, a whole mess of things. And of course, obviously the passion that goes into each of those forms are very important, depending on what form you're doing.
The guitar is amazing.
The guitar came in around the Romantic period. This is the cajon, yes, box.
And it's or percussion underneath box. Your cajones.
Yes, yes, that's, yes, that's actually true.
And now to the learning portion of our day. Nalida was going to teach me flamenco, or at least attempt to.
So, really simple?
No.
No,
no simple. Simple, no. Let's go for it.
One, these are golpes.
Golpes.
This is the easiest way that we use the beat.
Really?
Yes.
Just hit up the golpes. Good news is, I'm wearing my flamenco shoes today. These are actually called Nike Air Golpe.
One, two, three.
Is this the dance?
One, no, it's not. Okay. I'm just counting it for
you. I was going to say, because I got this.
Una pica.
I hit myself.
Una pica. Up.
Up. Palmas altas, not sortas.
Out, in, and out, and in.
Is there anybody underneath us right now?
No,
okay,
it
good.
Doesn't matter. Right
I just
now.
Don't want to wake up a baby. You know what I'm missing?
What?
Flecos. Should I pull my pants up?
Yeah.
Ole! Ole indeed.
Run, 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 run.
I think I might be obsessed with this dance and this music. I'm not joking.
So for those experiencing true flamenco for the first time, I hope you reacted the same way I did. Enraptured by its power and passion, an emotion that can't really be described, just felt. Watching Nalida, you begin to feel what she's feeling. Her pain, her pleasure, becomes yours. It's unlike any dance I've ever seen. It's centuries of history and dozens of cultures molding together with music playing with her, not for her. Like an invisible partner. It's incredible. Beautiful. In other words, it's flamenco.